The Silver Arrow. Listen to this story adapted from The Merry Adventures of Robin Hood. It was a sunny Wednesday in Nottingham. One of the sheriff's men came riding through the town. He took out a poster from his bag and hung it on a lamppost. A little boy was watching him. As soon as he left, the boy took the poster and ran off into the woods. "Where's Robin?" he shouted as he ran through Sherwood Forest. The boy was looking for Robin Hood, the best archer in all of England. Robin Hood was the leader of a group of outlaws called the Merry Men. They all lived in the forest and wore green jackets. Robin Hood took the poster from the boy and read it. "Lads, we are going to Nottingham," he called out to his band of outlaws. "The sheriff is holding an archery contest in 3 days, and the prize is a silver arrow." "Don't go, it's a trap. He's trying to capture you," said one of his men. "Nonsense, he'll never catch me," Robin Hood answered confidently. Robin Hood was once a nobleman. He was loyal to the king. When the king was fighting wars in far-off lands, he had left his brother, the prince, to rule in his absence. But the prince was an evil man. He took away the lands of all the noblemen who were loyal to the king. After Robin Hood's lands were taken away, he escaped into the forest. There, he found other people whom the prince had mistreated, and he taught them archery and fencing. The sheriff of Nottingham was as mean as the prince. He hated Robin Hood and the Merry Men because they robbed from the rich and helped the poor. He wanted to capture Robin Hood and imprison him forever. But Robin Hood always escaped. The archery contest was the sheriff's latest plan to capture Robin Hood. Robin Hood will not be able to resist participating in an archery tournament. "I will imprison him and his merry men when they come to compete," he said. "Capture anyone who's wearing green," he told his men. "Robin Hood cannot escape from me this time." On the day of the contest, the sheriff stood looking for the merry men. There was no sign of them. Finally, his chief officer said, "We must begin the match now. The people are getting impatient." The sheriff was disappointed that his plan had failed, but he started the contest anyway. Many people had come to watch the contest. They all cheered when an arrow hit close to the target. Everyone kept expecting Robin Hood to show up. Some archers wore red, others wore blue. There were archers in black, brown, and even purple, but no one wore green. Soon, there were only two archers left. One wore red and the other wore blue. They were both very good. The spectators grew more excited. Some shouted, "Bravo, Blue Jacket!" while others exclaimed, "Go, Red Jacket!" Finally, the man in the red jacket won the contest. The people cheered loudly as he went to receive his prize from the sheriff. The sheriff was angry. "You are lucky that Robin Hood and his merry men were too afraid to come here. You have won only because those cowards are not here," he mocked. The man in the red jacket accepted the silver arrow humbly from the sheriff. Then, turning to the sheriff's guards, he said, "Since the sheriff says there is someone better than me, I will shoot this arrow as far as it can go. The finder may keep it." As soon as he had shot the arrow, all the sheriff's greedy guards ran off, leaving him alone with the two archers. The sheriff was turning to leave when the man in the blue jacket stepped forward and tied his hands. At the same time, the man who had won the arrow threw off his red jacket and revealed his green outfit. Robin Hood and his merry men took the sheriff as their prisoner and went away to Sherwood Forest. "You are worth many silver arrows, Sheriff. I'll get my reward from the king when he returns," said Robin Hood.